Israel is being accused of using phosphorus shells in their attack on the Gaza Strip. Experts are saying that video shows the controversial weapons being used. The shells explode over their intended target, and the substance they contain rains down on the people below, causing severe burns. The weapons are criticized because they cover a wide range and harm civilians.
If it is used as a weapon, it would then be governed by the Chemical Weapons Convention. And we would certainly hope that Israel is not using it in this manner, particularly in such a densely populated area where you have civilians that could come into contact with this.
But a spokesman from the Israel military says they are doing nothing illegal.
And thirdly, all the ammunitions that we are using are with accordance to the international law, and as far as we know, are also being used in other militaries in the world, in the Western world.
Starbursts are lighting up the skies over Gaza. There's controversy right now growing over just what types of munitions are these and how they're being used. Our Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr has been looking into this.
Questions are being asked. What is this weapon? The Israelis exploded several times over Gaza. We showed the video to a defense expert.
White phosphorus. Really, Pete? White phosphorus shells, obviously. There's nothing else like it. That's obviously what it is, no doubt whatsoever.
But an Israeli official told CNN, quote, "I can tell you with certainty that white phosphorus is absolutely not being used. Israeli officials insist this is just smoke used to mask Israeli movements on the ground." Human rights activists believe the Israeli Defense Forces are using white phosphorus, an incendiary material that can badly burn anyone in its path.
But in populated closed areas, as in Gaza, where civilians can be affected from the burning particles, then it raises very, very serious concerns.
International protocols prohibit the use of incendiary weapons against civilian populations. In this video, it's not clear if the burning material falls on populated areas. In 2005, the U.S. military acknowledged using white phosphorus in Fallujah to flush out insurgents. Now, the Israelis may be using a similar strategy with a different goal.
Hamas combatants are going to see all these bright burning particles coming at them. They're going to put their heads down. They're going to stay indoors. And that's going to give the Israeli troops tens of seconds in which they can displace, they can move around out in the open.
Wolf, whatever these weapons are all about, the Israeli Defense Forces insist they abide by all international laws regarding the use of weapons and ammunition.
Now let's go to the tactics of Israel in this invasion. One, they're using white phosphorus. White phosphorus is a chemical weapon. For those of you who don't know, when it meets oxygen, and here's the funny thing about Earth, it's surrounded by oxygen, it produces a white smoke that then falls down on whoever's underneath it that burns your skin. But it doesn't just stop at the skin. It keeps going on a lot of occasions until it hits its bone. It causes second degree and third degree burns for sure. It is outlawed by the Geneva Conventions, but the clever folks in Israel and the United States, because we use it in Iraq and Israel used it earlier in Lebanon, have come up with an exception. Oh, don't worry, we're not using it as a weapon. If we did, of course, that would be a war crime. Instead, we're using it as a smoke screen or illumination. Oh, you didn't have any other ways to light up the sky, and so you chose to use a poison gas instead. Yeah, I would go for a different way of going about that objective. That was the excuse we mainly used in Iraq. The Israelis are saying, no, it's just a smoke screen so our soldiers can come in. Well, your soldiers wouldn't want to come in because then their skin would be burned off. You see, it's a chemical weapon outlawed by the Geneva Treaty of 1980. And by the way, this smoke screen is literally a smoke screen. There is no such exception. It just, they forgot to include, hey, don't also use it as a smoke screen. They said, don't use it as a weapon. And they said, aha, Well, if we don't use it, this chemical weapon as a weapon, then we could use it anyway. No, you can't. It's a war crime either way. Now, you're especially not supposed to use it in civilian populations. You know why? Because when it falls, it burns anyone underneath it. So if there are kids or women or elderly, or just flat-out civilians, they could even be men, that are not part of Hamas. It's possible in a city, when you drop it on a city. They get burned. They get burned alive. And then we invaded Iraq because they had weapons of mass destruction? Because they had chemical weapons? Come on, man. The hypocrisy of America and Israel these days knows no bounds. No bounds whatsoever. Now, that's okay, though, because they're fighting terrorists. As we burn the civilians alive, we're the good guys, so that's allowed. It's collateral damage. Come on, we're just using it as a smokescreen. That's all. Oh, everybody underneath it happened to be burned alive? Well, what can you do? We were using it as a smokescreen. It's hideous.